In this video, I'm going to graph the function y equals negative 2x squared minus 20x minus 27. So first of all, just by looking at this function here, I have no idea how the graph looks like. It may come across some x-intercept, it may not. But that's one thing I can tell is that the leading coefficient of x squared is negative 2. It's a negative number. That means the parabola is going to open downward like this. So basically, it's going to look like this with a maximum value here. So the best thing to do is don't try to figure out whether it like intercept any x-intercept or not, but let's find out what the vertex is. So the idea is that if the parabola is opening downward, and if the vertex of the parabola is actually above the x-axis, basically it would be around this region here, then you know if it opens downward, it will cross some x-intercept here. Then you may be able to factor it and then find out what the zeros are. Then you will have another 2 points, maybe somewhere across an x-intercept. But if the vertex is below the x-axis, maybe somewhere here, and you know the parabola is going to open downward, that means you will not have any x-intercept because it opens downward if the maximum point is actually below the x-axis. It's going to look like this, somewhere here, somewhere here, somewhere here, somewhere here. It will not touch the x-axis. So the best thing to do right now is let's find out what the vertex is. And we know one thing. To find out the x value of the vertex, you have a formula x equals to negative b over 2a. And all quadratic equation takes a form of y equals to ax squared plus bx plus c. So a is negative 2, b is negative 20, c is negative 47. So let's plug that in. X is equal to negative, b is negative 20, over 2 times a is negative 2. Negative 2. So this is negative, negative. So positive 20 over negative 4, basically it's negative 5. So the vertex has a value in negative 5. Basically it would be somewhere here. So we know that the vertex would go here. So this is the axis of symmetry. Okay. Then we want to know the y coordinate for this vertex as well. So what we need to do is just plug negative 5 into the y function. So basically y equals to negative 2 times negative 5 squared minus 20 times negative 5 minus 47. This is 25, negative 50. Negative 50, 50 plus 100, 50. 50 minus 47 is 3. So y is equal to 3. So we know that the vertex has an order pair, negative 5 and 3. So basically the vertex will be here. So negative 5 and 3. So we can write here. This will be the vertex of the parabola. So in order to graph a quadratic function, I would say you probably have to have 3 points so that you can actually draw the outline, but better if you can get 5 points. So let's do this. So let's draw the chart here, x and y. Now, let's get the points in the vicinity of the vertex. So x here is negative 5, so this is negative 5. And we have 3. So let's try negative 6 and negative 7. And let's try here negative 4 and negative 3. Let's plug in and see what the y value is. So let's plug in negative 7 first. So plug negative 7 into x here. So we have y equals to negative 2 times negative 7 squared minus 20 times negative 7 minus 47. What's that equal to? Well, this is 14. Oh no, 7 squared. 7 squared is 49. 49 times 2 is 2 times 49 times 2. Okay, let me put in the calculator. It's faster. 98. Negative 98 plus 140. Negative 140 minus 98. 42 minus 47. Negative 5. Negative 5. So this is negative 5. So I'll plug negative 6 into the x here, so y equals to negative 2 times negative 6 square minus 20 times negative 6 minus 47. 36 times negative 2, I think it's negative 72. Negative 72, this is 120, so 120 minus 72, because this one will become plus. 48 minus 47, 1. So this is 1. Let me double check this one here. Okay, should be negative 5. Okay, now we have this. Let's plug in negative 4. Square minus 20 times negative 4 minus 47. Let's see, that's 16, 16 times negative 2, 36, 32, negative 32, basically this is positive 80, 80 minus 32, minus 47, 1, so we have 1 here. Now plug negative 3, negative 3 squared, 20 times negative 3 minus 47. This one is 9. 9 times negative, now it's negative 18. 60 minus 18. 42 minus 47. Negative 5. So negative 5. Now it looks like it makes sense. Okay, with this value here, we can plot there. So we already plot the vertex. So let's plot negative 7 and negative 5. So I will extend this a little bit. Make a longer graph, negative 7. When it's negative 7, it's negative 5. So basically it will be here. Negative 5, y is negative 5, x will be negative 7. So it will be here. Negative 6 is 1. So when it's negative 6, this is 1 here. Over here, negative 4 is 1. So when it's negative 4, x is negative 4, y is 1. So 1 here. When x is negative 3 here, y is negative 5. So negative 3 and 5 here. So we plot these 5 points already. So we can actually connect this plot. So this will go here. Well, I'm using line paper, so yeah. But anyway, so this will go connected here. And this will be connecting here. And then down here. So it's an open downward parabola. Now, another additional piece of information is that, what is the y-intercept? That's another point. All you need to do is just plug 0 into x, you get a y-intercept, which is negative 47. So if this one, if you extend the graph here, and this will keep going down, this also keep going down, eventually this will intercept y equals to negative 47. Basically, if you keep going down like this here, and this will intersect y-axis at one point, this point will be negative 47. Okay, so that's the sketch of the parabola function of y equals negative 2x squared minus 20x minus 47. If you like my video, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.